Are you wondering whether you should get the Pfizer vaccine? Well, in this video, I'm gonna look at everything you should know about the vaccine. Coming up. This channel is about tips and advice to promote your health. Therefore, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and think your health. What is the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine? This is a messenger RNA vaccine. The FDA has issued an emergency use authorization for the prevention of COVID-19 on December 11th, 2020. How does the Pfizer coronavirus vaccine work? Well, how should I explain this? I'm standing in a room, and this room has four walls. So imagine that this room is a cell, and the four walls is the cell membrane. The inside of the room, this free space which you see around me, is the cytoplasm. And the fireplace behind me is the nucleus. So somehow we need to get the viral gene into this room. So imagine that the viral gene is this cookbook. But we don't need to bring the whole cookbook in. We don't have to bring the whole viral gene in. What the messenger RNA for this coronavirus is only part of this book. It's only one recipe from this book. So we take a recipe out, which is the messenger RNA, and this messenger RNA now comes into this room. What the messenger RNA is like a recipe. It tries to cook up something, and in this case, it cooks up a protein. So that's the way the messenger RNA translates the information to the protein in this room, which is the cytoplasma. Now the protein is made, and you get this. This is the protein. So what happens afterwards? The protein then goes just outside this room, outside the cell membrane, and the body sees this. Our body sees this as something foreign. And what does the body do when it sees something foreign? It starts building antibodies. And these antibodies are directed against this protein. This protein mimics the outside of the coronavirus, which is the spike protein. And then antibodies are made. So when antibodies are made, we have an immunity against the virus when the real virus attacks us. So if we do get an infection with COVID-19, the real virus, and we already have antibodies, these antibodies can then stick to the protein or the virus and prevent the virus from infecting the cell. Who should get the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine? The Pfizer vaccine is recommended for individuals 16 years of age or older who should not get the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine. You should not get the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine if you've had a severe allergic reaction after a previous dose of this vaccine, you have a severe allergic reaction to an ingredient of this vaccine. How effective is the Pfizer vaccine? The overall efficacy of the vaccine is 95%, and this we get from clinical data. Of course, the efficiency is different if we vaccinate lots and lots of people in terms of population, because the trial is done on 40,000 participants, but you have to translate this information to a larger population, which would include millions and millions of people worldwide. So what are the ingredients in the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine? Messenger RNA, lipids, salts, and sucrose. So imagine the messenger RNA as a long ticker tape carrying instruction. This is quite delicate. That's why Pfizer needs to keep the vaccine around minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 73 degrees centigrade. And then there are lipids or fats, and these are very small particles called nanoparticles, and they're used to encase the messenger RNA. Then there are salts. There are four different types of salts, and they're used to keep the pH of the vaccine close to that of the person's body. And sucrose is a sugar, and it stops the lipid nanoparticles from sticking together when the vaccine is frozen. Pfizer has stated that this mixture of messenger RNA and lipid nanoparticles are preservative-free. There is no timolol or any other preservative. And by the way, there are also no microchips hidden in this mixture. How many doses of this vaccine will be administered? So it's a two-dose vaccination series administered into the muscle, into the deltoid muscle, and the shots are given 3 weeks apart. When the vaccine is being administered, why will it be mixed with water containing sodium chloride? So sodium chloride is a chemical name, and it's the same name as salt or table salt. The reason for this is, and why this is being done, is that the vaccine is being administered so that the salt content is similar to the blood in your body. What are the main side effects of the vaccine? Injection site pain, tiredness, fatigue, headache, muscle pain, chills, joint pain, fever, injection site swelling, injection site redness, nausea, feeling unwell, and swollen lymph nodes. What can I do if I experience a serious side effect? You can get a serious side effect, but the chance is quite remote, quite rare. And a severe allergic reaction would occur within a few minutes to within 60 minutes after getting a dose of the vaccine. And signs of a severe allergic reaction include difficulty breathing, feeling a swelling in your face and your throat, a fast heartbeat, rash all over your body, you feel weak, you feel dizzy. And if you experience a severe allergic reaction, obviously call your doctor or go to the nearest hospital or call, if you're in the US, call 911. Will the Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine give me COVID-19? The answer is no. The Pfizer COVID-19 vaccine does not contain the SARS-CoV-2 virus and cannot give you COVID-19. Can individuals who have gotten sick with COVID-19 still benefit from getting vaccinated? So according to the CDC, and this was last updated on December 13th, the CDC recommends that people who have been sick with coronavirus, who have been tested COVID-19 positive, do get the vaccination. And the reason for this is they're not sure how long natural immunity lasts, whether it lasts a couple of weeks, a couple of months, or longer. And there's always the chance of getting reinfected. So when can I stop wearing a mask after I've been vaccinated? So currently the recommendations is to continue wearing your mask after being vaccinated. Because other factors which you need to look at are how many people do get vaccinated, and the spread of the COVID-19 in the various communities. So can you get sick with COVID-19 after being vaccinated? Yes, this can happen. So after you get vaccinated, it typically takes a couple of weeks for your body to build antibodies and therefore immunity. And it's possible for someone to get infected just before you get vaccinated or just after you get vaccinated. So will the vaccine cause a positive COVID-19 viral test? So the vaccine will not cause you to have a positive viral test. That test is used to test current infection. There is the possibility that you test positive for the antibody test indicating a past infection. And can the messenger RNA vaccine alter your DNA? So the messenger RNA only gives instructions, as explained earlier on, how to make a protein. The messenger RNA does not enter your cell nucleus. DNA is located in your cell nucleus. Messenger RNA only enters the cell's cytoplasm. Therefore, it cannot alter or interact with your DNA, and no changes are made to the DNA makeup. And if you're interested in a video looking at the details of corona vaccines, click on this link above. And if you want to see other videos, click right here, click right here, click right here. Think of health and have a good day. My hands are freezing. Maybe I'll go and cook something as well. Oh my God, I'm cold. You know, people don't realize that I'm doing this. It's like minus 30 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, maybe minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm a wuss.